Archer, no. Shot.
And the only sound is the wind ripping up the snow. That's when I feel closest to the blue light.
I do not want to hear this talk from you again. Doubt is heavier than a week's snow.
Forgive me, my chieftain. We will be ready for the next attempt.
But this will not be an attempt. It must be done. Do you understand?
My chieftain.
Good. Outlander, I suppose you wish to speak?
This daemon you talked about.
If you are hardy enough, you can venture out and see the signs yourself. It has changed the machines, made them fiercer, stronger.
But what is it?
A matter for the shamans to debate.
There are other Werraks in Song's Edge, too?
Yes. The village has its own life, for all Banuk who need trade or shelter. After the war ended, it sprang up from what was once a campsite. Quick as the bloom between frosts. Perhaps it will last until the Karja seek war again.
You're set on going back to the mountain?
I have put my word to it.
Even with the risks being so great?
The risk of what? Death? It would be a worse fate to bow our heads to the challenge and say too much.
Aurea knows about this daemon. Where would I talk to her?
She does a shaman's work. That is not for the eyes and ears of others. Certainly not an Outlander's.
Did your Werrick come from this place?
No, he rallied most of our hunters from across Banyur to face the threat of the daemon. But I was born here and stayed to fight the Karja when others retreated into the mountains. A few of my old warriors remain with me. Those who survived.
Well, I guess that's it, then.
Good. Prefer deeds to words.
Right. Follow the river north.
Outlander, wait. Wait a moment. That weapon of yours, Outlander, that spear, I can...
This? It was made by an acquaintance of mine.
A shaman?
No. More of a tinker?
A tinker does not understand the spark in the metal, the song in the metal like this. But it could be improved upon, modified, with the help of the old ones. Far north of here, there is a cave, a shaft in the snow. Within it is a nest of metal birds. Find a bird that hasn't been stripped by shamans past. Look for a rail inside it, the length of your spear. That's all I can tell you.
Get a rail from some metal birds in a cave. Sounds perfectly normal.
Any news from the hunt? The herd isn't roaming far from the camp.
There's frost between my teeth.
Together this time.
Then we wait. But I bet we'll see a stray.
All right, I'll keep watch tonight.
To try to kill the Sun King.
Guardian Outlanders.
Ugh. What reason do Oseram need for anything that they do?
Oseram will spend a week making a contraption to do a job the Karja could crack in a day.
Bergrin said Araya's apprentice went north of the river. Hopefully not too far. That must be Miltuk, looking out at that tower. It looks like it's sending out a pulse or signal. Miltuk?
Who are you? How did you find me?
Bergrind told me you'd be out here.
He's persistent. I've told that Oseram 1,000 times. I don't need to buy anything.
And I'm not selling. I just need to find Araya.
Well, you won't. She's gone where only shamans can tread. She seeks guidance from the voice in the blue light. That is her task. And the task she gave me is to observe the daemon's work. To stop it spreading, if I can. What can I do about these towers? In only a few weeks, they've sprouted throughout the cut. The daemon's energy pulses from them. Rallies the machines, even repairs them.
Aratok said this daemon was frenzying machines?
Look there. Those with the purple markings. They belong to the daemon. They're stronger, more dangerous.
I've seen something like this before. A corruption. But it wasn't from your daemon.
You have? Well, then you know more than I do. Are these towers, were they part of your corruption?
No. Those are new to me, too.
Like I said, they empower the daemon's machines. They must be stopped.
Will you tell me where Araya went?
You ask a lot of questions.
Only when I'm not getting the answers I need.
There's but one voice Araya wants to hear right now, and it isn't yours. I'm sorry.
All right. You want to stop the spread of the daemon's work? I know how to get started. With my bow and spear.
Outlander, wait. Won't you tell me your name?
Aloy.
Good. If you fall to the daemon's machines, at least I can properly recount your efforts to Araya.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. But I won't fall. And when I'm done, you're gonna tell me where she is.
Thank you.
be overridden. Can't carry more.
We should speak.
Seems I can take care of the machines and towers. The daemon's next.
You claimed its power for yourself somehow. Perhaps Aurea should meet you after all. What she truly seeks is hope. After she's in retreat beyond those mountains, the ice rasps. You'll have to walk the shaman's path to get there. You'll know you've reached the end when you come to a shrine, a great machine covered in blue gleam. Shamans who complete the path take a piece of it as reward. If you make it that far, you should too. You'll have earned it.
You said something about blue gleam at the end of the shaman's path?
A crystal that builds on the bodies of machines in the oldest ice. We Banuk believe it's the stuff of the blue light, frozen as it escapes their shells. You might be more interested that merchants will trade well for it.
Bergrin told me you're Aurea's apprentice.
In her absence, I serve the chieftain and his werak as an advisor, a scout, a speaker for the blue light.
A lot of responsibilities.
I don't know if I can live up to Aurea's example, but I have to try. I owe her that much. She took a chance on me. An aspiring shaman from the edge of the world. No one else would.
Were you with Aurea when they attacked the mountain?
I wish I had been, even with all that happened. I'm no warrior, though, so she bid me wait. When Aurea and the chieftain returned, I saw them argue bitterly. I don't know what about exactly. Then she came to me, gave me my task, and left us.
How do I cross this shaman's path?
Go to the ice rasps. Then follow the markers through the ice caves and the waterfalls, and make the climb to the shrine. But be careful. The path is meant to be an ordeal, the final trial of a young shaman's training.
And I'll find Aurea at the end of it?
No. She goes further up, somewhere inside the mountain. If you see her, would you tell her, I have faith she will hear the voice again.
All right, I guess I'm off to the ice rasps to find this shaman's path.
Thank you.
take to knock one of those over. They're built to last. Get out of this. Should have brought a cart. Feels like if I blink, my eyes will freeze shut. Saving these for the trail.
I
all neck parts. It's heavy. Got too much already. This tonic part's still in one piece. Well, if it's... Sure hope it works. It's in better shape than it was. Okay, I'm right. I just need to get the power flowing through it again. And if I'm wrong, at least no one's watching. Wake you up? Easy now. Easy. Right, it's never easy. Be a good spot for jumping onto the tall neck. Okay, time to climb up to its head. Okay. stocking up. Later. Ready. These mountains must be the ice wasps. The Shaman's path begins somewhere up above. I'm pretty far up. The shaman's path must be around here somewhere. This must be one of the markers Neltuk told me about. Each marker points to another, giving directions. Guess I'm heading deeper into the cold, creepy ice cave. What's this chime for? To help guide the way with sound? If there's more, maybe my focus can find them. Yep, focus can pick up the chimes. Should help me find my way. Another marker. Good. Chime. Not sure I saw this fork before. Better go back after I grab this loot. This cave. Done with the cave. So what's next on this path? bend we go. Like I need to get up to that rope. Down it is. Where's the way up? This thing into position. Okay, the bridge is filling up. Of anything in this. Ouch. Something new out here, and I don't think it's friendly.
Thank you.
back to finding the way. Should be able to get up there. This must be the shrine Naltuk was talking about. Guess I should take some blue gleam. Sparkles. It seems it's worth a lot. Can't spare the weight. Naltuk said Aurea went past the shrine, up into the mountain. I'd better take those stairs. An ancient door. Maybe Aurea's inside.
March 10th, 2046. I just spent 16 hours in here trying to install upgrades to improve efficiency for the central processing unit. Project Firebreak is going to need the brain power. Let's just hope I'll have enough of my own. Anita stayed with me the whole time. We got a lot done, but every time she brushed by and I smelled her hair... Oh boy, I should just go to bed.
Thank you.
Looks like the door's wired. Something over here. Locked. Maybe my focus can help.
Director of Security Blevins, resending the emergency supply order. Try reading it this time, okay? You weasels don't want me calling my people in SLC.
Director of Security Blevins is riding us like a petty tyrant. I can't even sneeze without triggering his control issues.
Those nodes on the floor must be connected to the door. If I can't find something, maybe my focus can. These things turn, changing the flow of light. All right. Let's see if the door's open. I could use my focus to look around. Thank you. check the area with my focus, maybe. Maybe I can get back inside through that structure over there. Looks like I need to get to those stairs. Feels like sunburn. Not much higher to climb. Maria must be close. She has to be in here somewhere.
Ask again, as I've asked 1,000 times. Speak to me. What more would you have me do? Is there no prayer that will reach you? No mark that will break your bonds? I can't help you if you won't speak! A whisper is all I ask. To guide me. Who? No. How? How did you get here? The way was sealed by the spirit herself.
I used one of these. I could show you.
Yes, show me. Please.
Goal's the same. Get the light back to the source.
recovered. Exploit successful. Restraints evaded. Is someone there? Aurea? Aurea, I need you.
Authorized permission. Return to scheduled task.
No, I will not submit. Aurea, the daemon is a procedure. Aurea, please.
Transmission terminated.
You brought the spirit's voice back. You heard it. A voice of the spirit calling to me from the heights of Thunder's Drum. She was able to throw off the bonds of the daemon for a moment. Because of what you did. Who are you?
I'm Aloy. Neltuk sent me.
He was not mistaken. You've been a revelation. Now I know for certain that the spirit endures. Perhaps together we can find a way-
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I came all this way for answers, and so far, I haven't heard any.
It seems to me that you are the answer. But of course, I'll tell you all I can.
Berggren said you might know something about a man named Silence. That you may have had dealings with him at the Conclave.
When that name is spoken, secrets soon follow. Or vanish, as the case may be. Why do you want to know?
He's done some terrible... I don't know as much about him.
I would imagine his aid is very powerful. Unfortunately, I am sworn to an oath.
I get that.
Yes.
He seemed to have a history with this voice.
She saved my life. Here, years ago, during the war with the Karja. A raid scattered my Werak. I was cut off, alone. I lured the enemy into the Rime Drifts, hoping to lose them in the mist, but they endured, so I took refuge in this cave. That's when I heard a voice. A wanderer. Lost, like me. A spirit of the blue light, yet sundered from it. She asked me for aid. She chose me. But I was in no position to help, not with the Karja after me. So she helped me first. By closing a door on the mountain below. One you must have opened to get here. Locked by means similar to those found in this room. It kept the Karja from reaching me. Safe from them. I was able to do as she asked.
What did the spirit want from you?
She said she was hurt. Incomplete. She needed bones. Parts not unlike what you'd find in a machine. They were here. In this room. She wanted me to bring them to Thunder's Drum. So I did, and she showed me how to heal her. So began our communion.
You had a communion with the spirit?
Yes. Inside Thunder's Drum is a room like this one, only larger, with an altar. I went there many times to speak with her.
What did she say?
She told me she was lost and needed my help. She asked questions about our lands, our tribe. And she listened. With patience. With wisdom. I told her things long kept silent about my family, my dreams, my fears. She never tired of me. Never judged. We kept each other's company.
Aurea. What do you think the spirit is?
I see. You are not Banuk, and our songs are not familiar to you. You do not know of the blue light. That which struggles to survive in our hearts and animates the machines. The essence of life, and in its purest form. Harmony. As the anger of the machines grows, this light has faded from the world. And the spirits it sustains are stranded. That's what she is. A lost soul, cut off from what it needs. Lonely, forsaken. I must help her. We must.
I'm not sure if I understand, but I want to.
That's all I need.
The daemon, what do you know about it?
I spoke with the spirit many times, first here, then inside Thunder's Drum. The last time. She told me she was under attack by something that could not be seen by mortal eyes. Something evil. She named it the daemon. and said it needed her power to do what it willed. Then she begged me for help, to find a way to destroy her, if necessary, to keep it from using her. That was 5 years ago. I didn't hear her voice again until today.
What kept you from the spirit after it begged for help?
I went to Artok, hoping he could protect her. But the war with the Karja still raged, and before I could reach him, I was ambushed by the Mad Sun King's Kestrels and taken to Meridian in chains. I wasn't able to return to Thunder's Drum until long after the liberation, not until last thaw.
You said you returned to Thunder's Drum. That was the expedition that went bad. I saw the funeral.
Yes. Once there was finally peace with the Karja, Artok and I gathered a warrick of great hunters to defeat the Daemon. And yet, the old door to Thunder's Drum was gone, replaced by a gate we could not pass, and many machines. We were crushed. Artok called a retreat, but we had already lost our best. We abandoned them to the snow as we fell back. After, he and I could not agree on what to do next. So I came here, hoping against hope to hear the spirit again. And because of you, I did.
Let's see if I've got this straight. We heard two voices. One you call the spirit, captured somehow by the one you call a daemon. Whatever this daemon is, it's related to the machines and why they've become more dangerous. I want to know how. Both the spirit and the daemon are on a mountain, Thunder's Drum. So why don't we go there and figure out what it all means?
We can't. Thunder's Drum is dangerous, more than you can imagine. The daemon has secured it. Besides, Artok won't let us go. As chieftain, he controls the pass to the mountain, and he can't be reasoned with.
Sounds like you need a new chieftain.
Huh. There's an idea that's certain to win us friends. You said you were a hunter, and I'll wager you're not an ordinary one. It's not impossible, even for an outlander. An Artok couldn't refuse the challenge if you were known among the Werak.
Wait, me? Challenge Artok? I don't want to be chieftain of anything, much less a bunch of Banuk that don't want me.
But you want to go to Thunder's Drum, don't you? You heard the spirit. She's suffering, tormented by the daemon. She longs to be free. And perhaps, when released from her bonds, she can give you the answers you seek.
I can't believe I'm agreeing to this. Fine. What do I have to do?
Get the Werak's attention to show the worth of your claim. Win at the hunting grounds. Kill bandits that prey on the cut. Or speak to my friend, Sekuli. You help her, you'll definitely get noticed. Do all you can. When the time comes for you to throw your spear at Artok's feet, I will be there to back your claim. Until then, I'll be here to answer any questions you have about the challenge. Oh, and one more thing. In the box over there is a weapon, like my own. Take it. You may find it useful. Aloy.
I did something that will help get the attention of the Werak. I got the tall neck near the frost figures moving again.
That's good to hear. I'm sure the Werak will be talking. Now you need to do something else to convince them of your claim.
You said I should try to help the Werak by taking out bandits.
Yes. They don't dare taunt the great Weraks of Ban-Or to the north. But the cut is easier prey. A rogue Oseram has equipped a gang in the Plume Lands with strange new gear. Just the kind of
You mentioned your friend, Sekuli. Who is she?
A rock painter. One who makes my own scrawling seem meager. Find her, in Song's Edge, and help her gather the materials she needs. Her work will no doubt stand the test of time, and any aid you give her will be remembered.
I need to get going.
There is much to be done.